patient till we finish the podcast. We need to benefit from, and it's a subject that many people or some people might have different understandings of it. What to be okay to have differences in and what not. But as a matter of fact, that as mentioned in the hadith or the verses of the Quran, the hadith, that for the Muslimin to be upon the truth, to be united upon the haqq, this is part of it. This is no doubt. That should be present in the heart of every Muslim. And the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a person should be pleased with. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise. So without repeating what's mentioned before, we'll continue inshaAllah ta'ala. After mentioning some of the verses of the Quran, it talks about al-i'tisam, to hold fast to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the deen of Islam, not to have tanazu' or disputes, because it's basically the key and the means for failure, and that the Muslims in general become weak as a result of this. And then he mentioned, rahimahullah, he said, وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى said, لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. Indeed, you have in the Prophet ﷺ the best example. This ayah is mentioned after the verse that we talked about yesterday in Surah Al-Imran. فبما رحمة من الله لنت لهم ولو كنت فظا غليظ القلب لانفضوا من حولك. Saying to the Prophet ﷺ, it's by the mercy of Allah that you, O Prophet of Allah, لنت لهم, you were lenient towards them, you were soft and lenient to them. وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضْلًا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ, if you were harsh physically and with your heart, then فَضْلُ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ, they would disperse from around you. So we have in the Prophet ﷺ the best example for a person to be lenient and to have a lenient and a soft heart towards the believers. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the believers, رُحَبَاءُ بَيْنَهُمْ, they are merciful towards one another at all times. They have mercy towards one another. This has nothing to do with being firm upon the haqq and upon enjoining good and forbidding evil and doing whatever is benefiting, as it will come inshallah. And then he says, وَقَالَ تَعَالَى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ, help one another on matters of righteousness and التَّقْوَى, the obedience of Allah and the fear of Allah. وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا, do not help one another on matters of إِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ, sin and transgression. And then he says, وَمِنْ أَعْمَمِ الْبِرِّ, from the greatest of righteousness is what? What is the greatest? One of the greatest righteousness is السعي في جمع كلمة المسلمين واتفاقهم بكل طريق. السعي, to be diligent and to bring the كلمة المسلمين, the word of the Muslimin, for it to be together, to be united, واتفاقهم بكل طريق, and for them to agree upon matters and whatever path feasible to bring this in reality. This is one of the great righteousness, is to bring the people together and the hearts together and for them to have these beautiful meetings. كما أن السعي في تفريق كلمة المسلمين من أعظم التعاون على الإثم. As also on the other hand, as the ayah says, from the ways of to disperse the word of the Muslimin and to make them disunited and having split and disputes and so on, from one of the greatest meanings of to help one another on sins and transgression. So to help one another matters of righteousness and goodness has many different things in it, one of which is the, one of the greatest of its meaning is when the people are doing something to bring their hearts together upon the truth. And the opposite of that is also true. Then he says, وَقَدْ قَصَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا فِي كِتَابِهِ سِيرَةَ الرُّسُلِ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قَصَّ فَمَا الْقَصَصِ, stories narrated to us in his book in the Quran, the life of the messengers of Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them with tabligh risalati, to convey the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَذَكَرَ نُصْحَهُمْ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned how the prophets of Allah, they had the concern towards their people, لِأُمَمِهِمْ, to the nations. وَحِرْصِهِمْ عَلَى اجْتِمَاعِهِمْ عَلَى الْإِسْلَامِ, and their eagerness for them to be together upon an Islam. Because you can look at it from different perspectives. The prophets of Allah, they were sent, and as a result of that message, people, they split to be believers versus disbelievers. So they splitted the people. They did not unite the people. But what he means here is that he made the believers united. He split the people with matters of al-Iman wal-Kufr, and then the believers, those who followed the messengers of Allah, the prophets of Allah, they united them, they made them upon the truth. And this is also part of the unity to their nations, even when they call them to the deen of Allah. They were calling them to be united upon al-Islam, to be united upon the haqq. وَنَهِيهِمْ عَلَى التَّفَرُّقِ وَالِاخْتِلَافِ بِمَا هُوَ كَثِيرٌ فِي الْقُرْآنِ. And they forbade them from dispersing and disputing, which is mentioned in many places in the Quran. وَكَذَلِكَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And this is also the Prophet عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. قَدْ أَبْدَى فِي هَذَا الْأَصْلِ وَأَعَادَ. أَبْدَى وَأَعَادَ. That means the Prophet ﷺ mentioned many things in it. أَبْدَى means from the beginning, وَأَعَادَ means return. Kept on saying it over and over again. Prophet ﷺ, many things from the Prophet ﷺ that gives that meaning. وَأَمَرَ بِاجْتِمَاعِ الْعِبَادِ. And he ordered the people, the slaves of Allah, to be together, and اجتماع, to be together. Not just the اجتماع الأبدان, not for the physical bodies to be together alone, but rather for the hearts to be together. Because the physical bodies can be together, and this is meant for the people to be physically together in their salah and so on. And how is that related to their hearts also to be together? وَنَهَى عَلَى التَّفَرُّقِ and moved the الْفَسَادِ. And he forbade them from a التَّفَرُّقِ, to split, that would lead them to a الْفَسَادِ. This is, again, it's a foundation of the deen. And when people know this, then when it comes to the inevitable, if it's correct to say, split or people are away from each other, it's an exception. It's not the core of this deen. The core of this deen is to bring things together. But if it happened by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise. But this is a religious order. This is something that it's a duty upon the Muslims to do something to bring their hearts together upon the truth and upon the goodness. And the Prophet ﷺ said in hadith المتفق عليه, لا تحسد ولا تناجش ولا تبغض ولا تدابر وكونوا عباد الله إخوانا المسلم أخو المسلم لا يظلم ولا يقتل ولا يكلم. Prophet ﷺ said, لا تحسد, do not envy one another, ولا تناجش, and do not make a najash, buying and selling with a najash. Najash is to raise a price of something without the intention to buy it, just to hurt the other person in an auction, for example. وَلَا تَبَغَضُهُمْ, do not hate one another. وَلَا تَبَغَضُهُمْ وَالْبُغْضُ, do not hate one another. وَلَا تَدَبَرُهُمْ, do not give your back to one another, meaning do not turn away from one another, which means of boycotting one another and the like of this. وَكُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانَهُ, and be, O slaves of Allah, brothers. And that's an action, وَكُونُوا, that means you have to take the means to achieve the brotherhood. المسلم وأخو المسلم, the Muslim is the brother of a Muslim. لا يظلمه, he does not wrong him and do injustice against him. وَلَا يَخْدُرُهُ, do not let him down when he needs him also. وَلَا يَكْذِبُهُ, and he does not lie to him, and he believes him whenever he speaks to him. So these are clear instructions, and this is in matters of dunya. And in matters of deen, if the hearts are upon this, it will bring all kinds of goodness. So if a person thinks that he is doing something because of the deen, but there's no hasad inside, there's no envy, there's no hatred for matters of dunya or whatever, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in the heart. So these things are to be observed in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us according to what the Prophet said. The hadith definitely needs for it to be expanded upon. He says, وَفِي صَيْحِ مُسْلِمْ عَنْ تَمِيمِ الدَّارِي قَالْ سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ سَلَّمَ نَقُولَ الدِّينُ مُسْلِمْ. The hadith, the famous hadith of the Prophet said, الدين النصيحة. The deen is about the nasiha. The nasiha is the concern in the heart, the purity of the heart towards the subject of the nasiha. قلنا لمن يا رسول الله, to who, Prophet of Allah, Messenger of Allah, he said to Allah, لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين عمد. The nasiha is to Allah, the purity of the heart towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Him alone and to believe in Him and to be obedient and so on. ولكتابه, to the book of Allah, to have the sincerity and the purity of the heart towards the book of Allah, to read it, to learn it and so on. ولرسوله, to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to obey Him and to follow His orders. وَلِأَئِمَّةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, to the leaders of the Muslims, to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them to be guided, to give them the proper companionship for those who are close to them, aids, and so on. وَعَمَّتِهِمْ, and to the masses of the Muslims. That means nothing is left. This is the nasiha. Then he says, وَمِنْ أَعْظَمِ نَصِيحَةِ الْمُسْلِمِ, from the greatest nasiha, and the concern towards the Muslimin, as it's mentioned in the hadith here, one of the greatest of it is فِي تَأْلِيفِ قُلُوبِهِمْ, in bringing their hearts together, وَاجْتِمَاعِهِمْ, for them to be together, وَنَهِيهِمْ عَنِ التَّفَرُّقِ, and to forbid them from a tafarruq, or being split and dispersed and disputed. وَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, in the hadith المتفق عليه, to Al-Ansar, to the people of Al-Ansar, to the people of Al-Madina, مُنَبِّهًا لَهُمْ بِمِنَّةِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِمْ بِهِدَايَتِهِمْ وَاجْتِمَاعِهِمْ وَغِنَاهُمْ بِسَبَبِهِ, when he said to them, to remind them of the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon them, that they were guided, and they were all together, and they were self-sufficient because of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, ya ma'ashar al-ansar, the famous incident when the Ansar found something in their hearts, when after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam liberated Mecca, and they thought that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam now is back to his people, and he's preferring them over the Ansar, the people of Al-Madinah. So the Prophet ﷺ brought them together and he said, ya ma'ashar al-ansar, O people of Al-Ansar, alam ajidkum dhullalan fahadakum Allahu bi, didn't I find you dhullalan, deviated, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided you by me? Mutafarriqeen, this is the shahid of the hadith, this is why the hadith is mentioned. Mutafarriqeen, you were dispersed and split and fighting with one another and so on. فَجَمَعَكُمْ اللَّهُ بِي, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought you together by me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you were ala, you were in need, فَأَغْنَاكُمْ اللَّهُ بِي, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you rich by me. كَمَا قَالْ كُلَّمَا قَالَ شَيْئًا, and every time the Prophet ﷺ says something of this, قَالُوا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمَنْ, Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَمَنْ, meaning the favor is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We don't claim anything for ourselves. And he did mention, of course, the end of the hadith when the Prophet ﷺ said to them, أَمَا تَرْضَوْنَ, don't you please that people go back to their homes with the shay or ba'ir, with the goats and the camels and the wealth, وَتَرْجِعُونَ أَنْتُمْ بِرَسُولِ اللَّهِ, and you go back to your places with the Messenger ﷺ, isn't that sufficient for you? So the point of the hadith here that Allah, he said that Allah, you were dispersed, you were split, and فجمعكم الله بي, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you together by me. So that means this is something for us to also reflect upon. People, the Muslimin need to be united upon what? Upon the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is alive, what are the people called, those who will disperse and split and go away? Munafiqeen, hypocrites. But the believers are all together, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commend them, they will be all together with him. They will be united with the Prophet ﷺ, obey his orders, and their willing is still continuing till the Day of Judgment. In the matters of the deen that is well known, and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ and his way and so on. And also for those who have authority over them, as the Prophet ﷺ said, for the people of knowledge and so on. And he will mention some of the things that might be valid for people to have differences, but it does not take them away from the fact that they are united in their hearts together. And it does not cause them to be in hatred towards one another. And then he said, وَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مُحَذِّرًا لِأَصْحَابِهِ, manners and orders from Allah, if we observe it truthfully, then our situation will be completely different. By Allah. He said, the Prophet ﷺ said, warning his companions, عَنْ تَبْلِيغِهِ الْكَلَامِ الْمُغَيِّلُ الْقُلُوبِ, that he said to them, warning them not to inform him, not to convey some kalam and some speech to the Prophet ﷺ that might change the hearts against other individuals. He said, لا يبلغني أحد عن أحد شيئا فإني أحب أن أخرج إليكم وأنا سيوصل. He said, none of you should convey to me from what someone else did or said or saw, because I love to come out to you while my heart, my sadr, is sound towards everyone. Meaning if someone comes to the Prophet ﷺ said so and so said this, this person did this, that means what? The Prophet ﷺ doesn't want his heart to change against anyone. He wants to go out in the same way to everyone without his heart being changed against anyone. That's the Prophet ﷺ. And he's the one in charge. And he's the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals to him that he protected his heart. And how about then those who after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Those who are hard, their hearts are contaminated and filth and so on. And this is ourselves. So how then can be that we love for people to tell us the faults of others and want to hear what this person said and what did he say about me and this and that and the qeel wa qal and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying it. بعض أصحابي في قتل بعض من الفتى. The Prophet ﷺ said, when some of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ meet Mashura, asked the Prophet ﷺ the permission to kill some of the hypocrites. Hypocrites are the worst evil that can happen to a community. They're more evil than the disbelievers than enemies. When they said that to the Prophet ﷺ, the Prophet ﷺ said, لا يتحدث الناس أن محمدا يقتل أصحابه. He forbade them of this and he said, so that people do not say that Muhammad is killing his companion and his people. Because to the people, the munafiqeen, they are part of his companions. To those who are away, to the enemies. So the enemies, which is the fiqh and the understanding of this hadith, as the ulama, they say, as it will come, inshallah ta'ala. Something for the believer, if they have it, it makes matters completely different in many aspects. How the enemies of the deen of Allah, they should see what from a distance to the believers. They should see from the believers, from the Muslims, as if they are what? As if they are one. So if there is differences and disputes and things like this, that should not be even shown to them. And we're talking about munafiqeen, those who have kufr inside. Not just those who have even, you know, evil things less than kufr. So this is something, again, with specific incidents, we have to definitely consult the people of knowledge. But these are principles. Principles to learn. Then applying it, it's a different story. We have to have more knowledge in that. But see how the Prophet ﷺ would forbade the Sahaba from killing the hypocrites, so that the people referring to the disbelievers and so on, so that they don't say that Muhammad ﷺ is killing his companions. Which, as he says here in the Munzari says, أي لما فيه من التنفير عن الإسلام عن الإسلام لمن لم يسلم. Because this has تنفير, people would repel away and run away from Islam for those who did not become a Muslim yet. And this is the reality that we see, right? Someone wants to be a Muslim and he looks at the Muslimin and he sees how they are, you know, with one another. Why would you want to come from a distance? And that's why it's a mercy of Allah upon someone to know Islam without really seeing what the Muslims are doing. But see how the duty of the Muslims and how this is a responsibility that they have, that the others, those who are not upon Islam, they don't see this bad behavior from the Muslims that would make them turn away from Islam. أي لما فيه من التنفير عن الإسلام لمن لم يسلم فتركهم وهم مستحقون القتل تأليفا. The Prophet ﷺ left them, even though they deserve to be killed, تأليفاً. For what reason? To bring the hearts together. So he left something that, and these people, they did so much harm and they're doing so much harm, but he left this action so that for the purpose of making the hearts together. It shows the importance of bringing the hearts together. وَكَانَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يُوصِي مَنْ يَبْعَثُمُ لِلْدِعَايَةِ لِدِينِ الْإِسْلَامِ وَتَعْلِيمِ الشَّرَاءِ. Prophet ﷺ, this is the last one because of the time, he would give the wasiyah and the advice when he sent someone to invite people to the deen. Sending someone to invite people to the deen, giving da'wah to the deen of Islam, and to teach them the deen. وَتَعْلِيمِ الشَّرَاعِ. To teach them the ahkam of the deen, the teachers of the deen. فَيَقُولْ, he would say, بَشِّرُوا وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا وَيَسِّرُوا وَلَا تُعَسِّرُوا وَتَطَاوَعُوا وَلَا تَخْتَلِفُوا. عين صحيح مسلم. Without the ziyadah, وَتَطَاوَعُوا وَلَا تَخْتَلِفُوا. And in Muslim, I'm with this statement, which means بَشِّرُوا, give glad tidings. Give the good news. وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا, do not make people repel away. But this is not based on one's desire, based on the deen of Allah. Not to change in the deen, thinking that you, if you are upon the deen, people would repel. If they repel based on the truth, then that's what can you do? You invite them to the truth of the deen of Islam. But بَشِّرُوا وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا وَيَسِّرُوا وَلَا تُعَسِّرُوا. Make it easy, do not make it difficult for them. And the deen is all use, the deen is all ease, with the knowledge of how to take people gradually in matters of goodness. وَتَطَاوَعُوا وَلَا تَخْتَلِفُوا. تَطَاوَعُوا, that means, from a ta'a, be obedient, But what does it mean تطوعوا? And this is always mentioned when people are two. When people are three, they have an amir, they obey the amir. So if they obey the amir, and the amir is kind to them, so it goes both ways. تطوعوا, obey one another. And when people are two, تطوعوا. Right, when they're two, you obey him and you obey him. What if they're saying they're two opposite things? Obey each other. You figure it out. But do not be in dispute. Right? That means don't be in dispute. Find a way where you can agree with one another. And this is, does not mean to compromise the deen as it will come. This is not about the deen to be compromised. وَلَا تَخْتَلِفُوا and do not be different from one another. And he said, وَلَا تَخْتَلِفُوا فَتَخْتَلِفَ قُلُوبُكُمْ do not be different, otherwise your hearts will be different. This is when he would make the line straight, alayhi salatu wasalam. So that the hearts are not different from one another. So the last thing that he فَأَخْبَرَ أَنَّ الْإِخْتِلَافَ الظَّاهِرِ سَبَبُ الْإِخْتِلَافِ. He mentioned that the physical differences in their actions would lead to the differences in the hearts. Would lead to the difference in the heart. That's why a sincere advice. If we are not joining the rules now, we need to make sure that this is not the deen. This is an exception. So that nobody would reach a state where he's happy with us. Because some people, they like the fact that everybody has their own space, where you can breathe. But this is an exception. This is not how the norm is. Till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshaAllah ta'ala, permit for us to be back together. And if this is done in a normal situation, that will bring the hearts to be against one another. So that means people in these exceptional times, they need to work more on their deen, on their iman, so that the hearts are not against one another. And one of the things that people do also with this is this pandemic and this and these types of matters make people even with enmity towards one another. They're disputing with one another over these types of matters. So as long as the hearts are together, it's okay. It's a valid thing for people to have opinions, and we have to refer to the people of knowledge, of course, and so on. But this is to have differences in the hearts and for people to have fitna and enmity. This is not part of the deen of Islam. It's something that has to be the opposite, especially when it's a matter like this, not a matter of clear halal and haram and things of that nature, especially if it's a disputable or a matter of exceptional matter. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with this and more from this beautiful book inshallah ta'ala about being united upon the truth. صلى الله عليه وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه.